Let's talk a little bit about screening today here on LandBeat and what's the best thing to use for screening out food plots. What's the answer in what is the best thing to plant for screening? Well, it depends. And it always comes back to your goals and what you're trying to achieve. Here on the Woodlands, this farm, we're going to use several different species to help achieve our goals for screening out a food plot and allowing us to still maneuver through the property without blowing the deer out of the food plot.
And you say plant species, but we're talking plant types as well.
That's right.
You're talking about a mixture of evergreens to a mixture of shrubs and grass, really beefing up this edge so you can access around it and shield yourself from that. So it's extremely diverse.
It's very diverse, but also very beneficial.
Yeah.
Because I'm thinking 12 months out of the year and what a deer needs or a rabbit
sure.
or a turkey needs to better its chances of survival throughout the year.
Yep.
So we chose, just because they're near and dear to my heart, shortleaf pine, the only native pine species in Missouri. That's our first row of trees from the road. Then we go into shortleaf pine. Then we're going into a native species of shrub, which happens to be roughleaf dogwood. Then we're going to roll into about a 12-foot strip of switchgrass.
Right.
Then we're going to roll into a diverse area of
pollinators
and shorter grass. So we have several different things here.
I know someone's out there thinking, well, shoot, I've seen a shortleaf pine before. It doesn't have the conical shape, the iconic, kind of a single stem, then bushes out. But I think we need to go back and think about the fact that that's not the only line of protection when it comes to a screen.
That's right.
This, in the first couple years, let's say 7-8 years, it's gonna be a wonderful size, but then that's gonna give time for the shrubs to beefen up and go from a single stem to more of a cluster colony,
mm-hmm.
right? So then that's gonna take place over, you know, 5-6 foot tall over that time frame. Then the switchgrass will have plenty of time to come in, so you have multiple lines of defense. It's not like you're relying just on that shortleaf pine, but it is native and it has its implication in relation to the rest of the things that are growing next to it.
Yes, and beyond this is a food plot. So you think about late season, we've got great thermal cover. After season, February, March, and they really need to get in out of the snow or out of the wind, they have the pines here. Then they have the woody browse availability with the shrubs, but they're not gonna completely over-browse it because we have a lot of shrubs planted here. And then they can also use the grass for bedding and wind block as well, if needed later in season after, because they're not going to be using this in November because the
right.
weather's just not that bad.
In this region, it's not that bad that you
Correct.
Can compete with this from bedding, because obviously outside of this food plot too,
oh, yeah.
the timber is thinned and there are designated bedding thickets everywhere across this property. So it would just be for a small time frame, and that time frame weather-wise is outside of season. So
That's
it's
right.
not like you're trying to do too much with one thing and then impede your access. It all works out when you think about the system, if you will, in relation to climate, the region, and what else is happening across the property.
That's right.